So you get a wonderful picture of tough cuts, in fact. Whatever. So you get the first view of our workshop in the beginning, 64. It was built just after the Gobins, who, as you say, in the instigation of Prime Minister, with some rail workshops and all around a dyeing workshop. In fact, Gobins is a dyeing workshop with along a little river, and we need to have some French production because all production come from Belgium, and we want to have with economic autarcy proposed. So Gobins was just for the king and embassy gifts, and the need for aristocracy to have another workshop was done so in Beauvais. They bring some weavers from Oudenard with a little workshop specialized in green which we call perdure, you know, with some leaves, something like that. And we were specialized in the 19th century with some enjambment pictures, pastorals. Here is a tapestry was known at the Met from Boucher, who is king painter. It's called the Peep Show because there are some little pictures like Chinese theater. And this is the Russian Games. So you can have a view of what's attractive for commissioners at this time. In Gobins, we have to represent the history of the king, because there is the academy, and it is propaganda for the government. And in Beauvais, it is for the pleasure. So it was the beginning of Orientalism mood. So that's why we are famous now. Here is hunting, hanging from Louis XV, yeah. And you got a screen from Audrey, who is our director and famous painter. He specialized in hunting scenes. Louis XV loves hunting, so that's why he's his favorite painter. You got, I think it is the good size for the screen on this part. So it was, 12 red centimeters. It's a long time ago. Here you have a view of the whole workshop with all weavers on lines. Here is the abattoir, the whole Beauvais abattoir, where we are now. So, in fact, in the Second War, all the city was destroyed. Yeah. Just nothing of the cathedral and one or two very old houses. Before, it was one of the main cities in France. Now it is a neighbor of Paris, because all the history is gone away. And that's why public region, municipalities, and government want to return back to Beauvais to make part of its history was gone away. So here is the workshop now. So like here, the aperture was in 1989, and so we are in old factory from the 19th, and the rebuilding was with the needs of weavers. So I think with dovecotes and this place, we we are in the same relation. You can see our lower plumes with a little tapestry from Texier on the wall, I mean. And that is a work from Philippe Richard. You get to have artworks because it's a suit. And on Thursday there will be the cutoff. So this is a detail from this. It's very simple one. We just use some yellow silk in this part. I show you this because I think there are some similar with Nati's works with the dots. And here's the two others were already there. Yeah, this is a detail with the opposite of the double thread. Here is a new project we accept, will happen, for the room of François Premier at the Chambord Castle. So this is a tapestry who was woven in 1508 for the mother of François Premier. He wasn't still the king, and his mother make a lot of craft works to remember to everyone that his son could be the king. And she was right. So it's interesting because you get the armories of his family, Angoulême and Savoie. So this is a new generation of king who's called the Valois, and it is the beginning of the rebirth in France. So really it should be the end of the Manierism. I think it's a very decorative one because you got a lot. There is one tapestry was known in Vatican, was just more painting copy. In Middle Age, with 1,000 flowers, we were in a very decorative within. And with Raphael, it began the end of something more interpretive that we have to follow the artist. So it just before. Raphael tapestries for Vatican rooms are from 1525. And so this tapestry is now in the Boston Museum of Fine Arts. And the conservators of Chambord Castle want to make a copy of it, but as a new one with original colors, in fact, like an immersive proposition in the room. Because Castle Chambord now is, there's nothing in, so they try to make some furnitures in that for the visits we are understanding it would be at
Pierre, was the decision made to weave it to the colours that were as they existed when they were made, or the colours that it's faded to now?
No, as it should be. So I would show you this is just an arrangement of the tapestry. In fact, what is a little bit difficult for us is we have started with the tapestry and not the artwork, as usually we have to do. And what's interesting is how we are using some techniques we have forgotten now, but we will try to not make a copy of it, but they have perceived it. And so this is our first sample. And we start with the dyeing workshop. We get some samples of vegetable tunes. And so there are a lot We know that they don't practice it in the 15th, but in the 18th, because there is potassium, something like that. So we have the tapestry was an exhibit since 2 years, so we can have a look on and make a lot of pictures to remembering. And that's all for this. This is one of our last project was done now in, it's gone to Abu Dhabi Louvre Museum for the aperture. It is commissioned with an Abu Dhabian designer, and he visited all the workshops from the Mobile National, and he was interested in how we organize the colors. So we are an organization was done by Chevreul, who was our director at the end of the 19th century, and he make a classification of colors with a circle or turn around with 72 tones, normal ones, and after they were more saturated and more darker. So now we get a classification of 12,200 colors. So he was really impressed him. And here you get one big stripe, and each little one are for 1 hour. So in 1 day you get two parts of these 12 colors, and each month there is a graduation. So you can have the 12 months with a mix in the beginning of a new season. And at the end it make 340 meters long. So this is one part. It's not really interesting for us, because we have just to weave some stripes.
Are they all your weavers?
Sorry? No, no. There's a lot of people who are working in Mobile National, administration, I don't know, industry, people who are conservative lights. Here it's a project from a Letton artist with a weaver too, and he's working with big pieces with chaff, 70, chaff. Yes. And so the back is the linen, and you use copper, copper threads. And here is a microprocessor drawing, and there is a lot of drawings from each important decorative times. So here is our artwork with how do you say it?
Cartoon.
No, this is a gate of Baguette
de Gare.
So it was a draw of a part of this Bagatelle gate. And here you get first samples. We try many different natural threads with horses, camphor, like cannabis. We try with the natural linen there, but in fact we find it too like a mutual thing, you know, with the purple and the silver. So we made just a little colors to make it more warm. And at the beginning, it just want to have two colors. We decided to make something with a piece to try to find the light in. So we get three purple hua in the red part and fioven the blue one. And we can mix all together to make a yes, if you, but try to stay in a minimalist form as well. So here is an arrangement, and the drawing will be stitched on the loom. And here you can see two weavers who are looking on the mirror in the other side, because we are working in the back side, not as you can see here.
Oh.
And the other mirror is to see if you can. The arrangement, because all is in the back. And there is another weaver who is making a hand enlargement, a square enlargement. Here is the mezzanine of the factory where we can make all the arrangement and the end finishings, stitching finishings for big carpets and tapestries. So that's where we are now. So that's when we need to see the work, the looms can be rolled on top. And you have the captain who stitch. That is another project from Agil Sprozendek, I told you, which is done in Paris. Because we have two workshops. One is returned in Beauvais, but the other who was installed near the Goblins is still there. So a different interpretation. That's to show to Chris one of our circle tapestries. So here it's we need to make the draw of the circle before, and at the end we cut it off. And I will show you how it will be back. In fact, just for information, we use some carbon sticks, like for the tent, if you can't. But you can see tension make it like a dish. I don't think it's a real good form for it. So that is our main project. Now, you have Claude Ruteau is a French artist who in 1968 have, I think, the same radical positions than Daniel Buren, maybe, who make just stripes, and try to make difficult, very conceptual artist, but to fight the paintings. So at the beginning, there is just it's just writing some definitions. He doesn't paint anymore, and the first definition was you have to make on how you call these things
square.
Okay, we said squares. And the same color than the wall. And that's all. And curators, for example, have to make their own painting from the wall who is in the back. So here it's an installation in a National Contemporary Museum, Beaubourg, in Paris. And that's another, it's an installation in Versailles. With marble, and what's interesting him so is he doesn't anymore make some pictures. So since 2 years he had to think about what is tapestry and what are the specialties of the unicorn handling. He start to show something about sensitive, because in the original one you get to the four sense and on another. So here is some of the beginning project for the carpet, who will be with tapestries. And so you can have a look on the original. So five cents, and Amos El Desir, to my only one desire, who will be the carpet. So for the carpet, we keep the island, the blue island, and that's one of our first proposition, because in fact it just commissioned us to make the artwork. So the idea is to disappear what's on, like we forgot now what it could be. So this is an optical transformation, and now this is a final, the beginning of the final project. So this is the sight. The sight.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yes,
the touch. The
that one.
The ring. The taste, and the smell.
Smell.
And the final project for the carpet. With the treatment, it is a Photoshop treatment, digital one. He wants that what's happening with the digital programs, that we, it's out of our control. So there's something was up here that we don't know at the beginning. And with this rise, we have to be in a relation with the front of the suit. So that's the tapestries were not finished. We have the site, and what to say? Hearing.
Where are these hanging?
In the workshop now. We are waiting that the end of the suit, and I have a visit of the curators from Cluny. So normally in June there will be in an exhibit with the original ones. Mm.
In the Cluny or here in
New
South Cluny. Wales?
In okay. Cluny, yes.
Okay.
So that is normal, but it's not for that that it happens anyway.
How lovely.
The carpet won't be finished at this time, so maybe there is something a little different with a scale. I don't know, the artist is thinking about. And here are the others. So this is that, for example, it's for the beginning of this, but it was too. We are like in between the fourth and the fifth in the disappearing of the picture, so we cut it away and start another one. Here you can see how we are working on. So this is a touch, and when we are rolling the loom. So here we are with the taste, with my favorite one, and the bigger. And for this, everyone got his own feeling. It is like surrealism games. So the main weaver, master weaver, will start with the sight. I define a technique with a half pass snatching. And we were in Cluny just to have a look on the originals, and after that we turn back and make the color's choice about the remembering of. And everyone have to use the same colors and the same techniques, but they can make some little modification. So everyone on his own have to be in the following of the others. And this is the most saturated, because it's the taste, and we want it more. you get a detail, and you can see how we practice the self-pasta chin. And all is on one line. So for the site, we got 72 different bobbins we have to join together. It's very hard to work. And the last one. So it's not monochrome. But just stay just one little thing. And at the end, it will be joined to squares from same dimension than each tapestries, and will be the process of the artist with the color of the wall. And if you got a natural wall with stones, it will be a natural linen square. Another project was done now from Vincent Borer, who is middle designer, middle artist. He was inspired by the Oxford mystery. This is the artwork. This is one of his own sample for his own artwork. It's with a mix of scents, colored scents. And he wants that we are using the same perception of the color. So here it's just an imprint, but he wants that all was mixed together. So here the font is with 80 different colors, because we got with the half pass. There is just one red with always on all the piece, and after you get middle of purple red color and the other in the orange, and you get green in circle parts and blue, just little points. Because he wants that the vibe and the perception will not be closed. He's talking about mature colors. That's our new project we are expecting. Is a network for national. How can I say that? It is like a state bank, you know. Everything with we have to be wait for the pay. I don't know how to explain it in English. Whatever. So this is a special permission, as you have not here, because normally we are working for state collections. So what you have seen before, when it, at the end it turned to the collection of the Mobilier National, and if someone in the public state buildings need it, you can choose it. So sometimes at the end you can wait for 10 years. Here we have a lot who are in Élysée, in the president's place, because we have a new president who loves modern tapestries, and that's good for us. So here it's for a special place. So the artist had think about the arc of the entrance, and he had to make some symbols we don't know, see them very well. About the fountain, with the beginning of the symbol of this bank. And the other one is from National Commission for Free Information, who have to survey about our personal information on the net available. It makes 3 meters high. The other is four meters. This is 3 meters high and two large. It's a lot of work. I think we have to use 7 feet for this box. And maybe we will use the workshops, the broderie and lace workshops for the white lines, I think. Here we are, and when I turn back, I have to. I need the visit of the artist because to start samples. And last one from Isabelle Champion-Métallier, with a mix with velvet. Velvet? Yeah. I think it's very decorative and with some. It's difficult to place modern tapestries in some ministries because they are from the 18th centuries. And this, I think, there is something in relation. Here is a tapestry where you can see the first sample on the table. So it was for us very a new way of thinking because it's a photo and it's some clothes who are still woven, and we have to represent the image and not the weaving of it. So we have to have the perception. The photographer tried to have all in the same level, so he's using lights. No, it's not the real perception of it. So we get etching for this part. One special half bust point for the t-shirt, using linen, white linen, like your cotton for the white t-shirt. This is a portrait of Klaus Winkler. It's a German artist. There is a birthday, 80 years old birthday, I think, this month. There's a great exhibition in Germany. At the beginning, it's a newspaper photo of himself that he had painted. It means. So he's a German. His father was in an SA. So he had a lot of troubles with his family and the German history. So he is like a witness of history. And the white painting on his face is all being the future. That they are the lines were marked him, but whatever is still alive, and Germany is still alive, and what we have to keep is the look, because humanity is in the look. And we get an installation with liver threads. Mm-hmm. Because it means like it's like the God finger, and as an artist, it's got a big ego, and whatever God try to. it's woven with 600% of linen, mixed with wool. Because he wants that it is like rustic. Yes. So you don't want that too clean, like we normally do. That would be, in this part we had pastel, an iron. It's wrong. So in the other side, we don't touch anything.
How many warps per centimeter?
Sorry?
How far? How many warps
swaps
it?
Not a lot, I think. Three and a half.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. We start to become like you.
Fast.
And there is a lot of form drawings. Mm-hmm. For the tension. Mm-hmm. And in fact, Leiden is not reactive, same as the wool. Mm-hmm. So no, it can have a lot of tension in wool steel. This is another portrait. This is an artist who still in the 70s work on herself. In different, in fact, it is about a different way of the woman representation in the world. And so here is the beginning of a suit who's called Protocolombian Disfiguration. And it's a mix of his own portrait and of a Colombian pottery. So this is the artwork, it's a digital photo, and that is from the other side, because
yeah,
I like it. And you can see this special lady. But it's a real interest, because she had met a lot of performers in the beginning of the 70s. She's working on hybridization, on digital links before net appears, and on the body. In fact, she's now, she had made a lot of aesthetic operation.
Cosmetic.
She used like in the Venus of Botticelli. Mm-hmm. She has, we don't see it, but normally she has the same mouth. The eyes are from La Joconde. So it's a mix on herself, and it was a lot of performance when in the operation there are camera. And the medical staff wearing special clothes, a lot of things like that. She got a lot of chairs from herself. It's special, real special. But for us, it's really interesting because she's one of our famous artists, and in something with commission like that. You get in our collection the artist, something with, I think, a real textile at the end. And sometimes we don't like what we have to do, but it should be interesting in the weaving. Sometimes the idea is good, but not interesting. Here there is all the things on, I think. And you get on left, it was a tapestry from just after the First War, from Louis Antin. Was called the mobilization, yeah, or departure. And it is to make the link with this from Michel Aubry, with our work for this centenary. This is an Aryan picture of the land of Verdun, when it was one of the most awful battles. And the blue one is, the red one is a picture from 1916. The blue from the 50s, and that's what it happens now. So our there are always some stigmates with the digging, the line, the digs,
in fact. I have no details, but if someone, yes. Because for the forest, we make a lot of little things in 3D. And that is a Pieta from Aubusson. It was commissioned by the German government. So it is a lot of little schools who make the draw. You have seen
yes, this it, was so made in Aubusson.
Yeah.
And we saw it this year. We weren't allowed to photograph it, but it is enormous. It would be from probably the ceiling up there yeah. to the floor. And it's made up of tiny skulls, so all those gradations in tone are made up of the little skulls, little woven skulls here.
Amazing.
And of course it's Michelangelo's Pietà, and it's for the First World War, it's just been unveiled in Alsace.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amazingly ambitious project for a government to commission that.
Yeah. And it was made in 4 months.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
4 or 5 months,
3 weavers.
3 weavers.
Oh.
So it's coarse.
So they don't
it's
sleep in the
evening. No, they don't sleep.
That's what they are.
It's just drool.
Hmm? Two.
Just drool.
That's drool.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just two weavers.
To for the interpretation, there is no interpretation, you just have a
following. Nice yeah, following, drawing. Yes, following the drawing completely, yes, yes.
I had to.